Hello designers, and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at Boolean operations. I will show you how each one of these geometry tools works, and I'll also cover how to use them non-destructively. In Affinity Designer, Boolean operations are a set of operations that allow you to combine previously drawn shapes that overlap, like the ones I'm highlighting down below. Affinity Designer provides us with geometry tools, and these allow us to combine our shapes. In the top right-hand corner of my screen, you'll see grayed out icons, and it says geometry underneath. If I go ahead and select two shapes, you can see they are now highlighted. And I've recreated this in Affinity Designer so you can see a bit more up close. You can see the tools here: add, subtract, intersect, XOR, and divide. Let's jump in and see how each one of these tools works. Starting off with the add tool. The add tool creates a new object from the sum of the selected objects. As you can see here, I've got a blue square and an orange circle. Now I need to highlight both of them for this to work. So I can use the move tool, which is the arrow, to click and drag over the shapes I'd like, and you can see they're both highlighted now, and you can also see this in the layers panel. This can be quite hard if you have multiple objects on screen, so I suggest either click on the first object and click the second object, but first hold down shift and click. So you can see now they're both selected, and you can see that in the layers panel. Alternatively, you could just head to the layers panel. Here, I'll select one of the shapes and I will keep my finger on command and select the next object. And you can see they're both selected. If you look up in the toolbar, you can see the geometry tools up here. The first one, if we hover over it, says add. Let's click that. Okay, you can now see that in the layers panel, I only have one shape. There's not two anymore. It's combined both of those shapes into one. You can also see this one shape is now blue. If I just step back a little bit by pressing Command Z, you can see that the blue layer, the blue shape, is underneath. If we go to the layers panel, you can see on top is the orange shape and on the bottom is the blue square. When using these tools, the new shape that you create always takes on the color of the lower layer. So let's do it again, highlight both of them and click add, and you can see it's one shape. If I go to the node tool, you'll see it is just one shape. The subtract tool removes overlapped areas of the lowest object. Okay, so let's use this. On top is our orange circle and underneath is the blue square. Let's select both of them and head up to the geometry tools. And if I hover over, it says subtract. Let's click on that. And you can see now that the square has a bite out of it in the shape of a circle. So the circle has disappeared. It's been discarded. And what you're left with is this square shape with this bite out of it. The intersect tool creates a new object from the overlapping areas of the selected objects. So if you look in the icon, you can see we have our two shapes here. And you can see the blue selected highlighted section of the circle. That's the bit we're going to be left with. So on our two shapes here, we're going to select both of them and head up to the geometry tools. And I'm going to select intersect. Now you can see we're just left with that quarter of the circle, just like the icon shows us. And that's the intersect tool. The XOR tool merges objects into a composite object with a transparent area where filled regions overlap. That's what the manual says online on the Affinity help section. And I had to actually look up what XOR meant. And it means exclusive OR. But regardless, this is how you use this tool. Now, if we select both objects again, we'll head up to the geometry tools. XOR is highlighted. And I'll just click on that. You can see here, it's made one shape. If you look in the layers panel, it's made one shape, and this bit is apparently transparent. So let's test that out. So I'm going to draw a shape behind our current shape just to test the transparency of this section. So I'm going to go up to the toolbar and I'm going to click on insert behind the selection. I'm going to choose any shape. I'll just go for the rectangle tool. There we go. Drawn it, and you can see it is transparent. So that is what the XOR tool can do for you. And lastly, the divide tool. This one splits object areas into separate shapes. So again, let's select both of them, head on up to the geometry tools and click divide. So it should be split up into three sections now. So I'm just going to pull this one away and I'm going to pull this away. And you can see there are now three separate shapes. That is the divide tool. So I've shown you before how to use the geometry tools. And if I show you again, let's just go over one of them again. Let's go for the subtract tool. You can see on the subtract tool, we've used it. It's made two of our shapes, two of our layers, into one shape, as you can see here in the layers panel. And if I just go to the node tool, you can see what it's done. I can't really do anything more than this, as I've just got one shape. And the only way for me to go back, if I've made a mistake, is to press Command Z, and we're back to our two shapes that we can move around. So now I want to show you how to create non-destructive compounds with Boolean operations. As before, we have our two shapes, and we're going to select both of them like we did before. We're going to head up to the geometry tools, and we're going to hover over subtract. I want you to keep your finger on Alt. This is on a Mac, and click. You can see now in the layers panel, this is called compound. We've created a compound layer. And you can see it's got a little arrow here with a drop down. So if I click on that, you can see we still have two shapes. So it has cut out, the circle has cut out of the blue square, but I can also make changes to this. So this has been non-destructively edited, so to speak. So if I just grab the circle, I can now move it around wherever I wish. And you can see it's just one shape. And you can still see behind it, if I hover over this heading I've created, you can still see it's transparent. So it has cut that circle out of the square. Also, if you look in the layers panel, look at the circle shape. Next to it is an icon with the subtract icon. If I click on that, you can see we're given a set of options and we can cycle through all of those geometry tools. So if we go to intersect, or let's go to intersect next, if I click on that, now I can use the circle to highlight the square. So the square has been clipped. Creating non-destructive compounds is very handy, as you can see. So we've created our compound. And what if we don't want that anymore? What if we want to unpack those shapes back to the way they were before? Sure, we can press Command Z until we skip back a few steps. But if we head up to the layer option up here, click on that and you can click Release Compound. You can now see we have our two shapes like we did before. To briefly go over what I've just shown you, we've used the destructive method and the non-destructive compound. Let's go over it again real quick. Select them both and click Add. That's created one shape. If we go to the node tool, you can see it's just one shape. Let's do the non-destructive compound. We'll select both of them and we will select Add, but first we will click on Alt, keep our finger on it, and click Add. You can see they both look the same, but if we head over here to the layers panel, you can see the first object we've got here is, it just says curve because it's one shape, and underneath is our compound shape. And as you can see, we can still make the changes we need to. So it can be very handy to use a non-destructive compound. Also, you can create shapes within the compound. So let's use a heart shape. I will draw that. And you can see it's been added into this compound. So you can add whatever you need to in there. And also with each shape you create, the icon is there in the layers panel, and you could press subtract on that. So now that's subtracted from the square as the heart is above the square. We drag it on the layers panel over the circle. You can now see that it is subtracted from both shapes. And to test that out, let's just grab the compound. If we drag it over this text, you can see it has worked. Thanks a lot for watching. If you enjoyed this tutorial, consider subscribing, leave me a comment, and I'll see you on the next video.